In recent news, Real Housewives of Atlanta star Porsha Williams is engaged. Fans were shocked when she revealed her new fiancé is her co-star's ex-husband, and despite having her fair share of relationship drama, this was a surprise to say the least. While that's all hard to keep up with, today we're going to be checking out something that's a little easier to follow, her real estate. After divorcing her husband in 2013, Porsha bought her own mansion in 2016, a sprawling estate in Duluth, Georgia for $1.15 million, where she still calls home to this day. Check out a couple of her properties, we even found the listings. In these videos, we don't reveal any addresses, and even though I've done a house tour of my own place, please do not show up at any private residences because it's not safe for anyone. Porsha Williams is a TV personality and actress best known for starring on the reality show The Real Housewives of Atlanta since its fifth season in 2012. Not to mention, she also starred on Dish Nation since its second season in 2013 and was featured on The New Celebrity Apprentice in 2017. Porsha's former marriage to football player Cordell Stewart was always in the public eye, and not only was their wedding featured on the show Platinum Weddings, the two were also a couple when she started in Real Housewives. Unfortunately, they divorced in 2012, and Porsha would go on to have some new relationship drama, often shown on the reality series. She was engaged to entrepreneur Dennis McKinley, and the pair also had a child together, but since Dennis was unfaithful, the two wouldn't last. Porsha was on and off with her ex-fiancé for a number of seasons, but in recent news, she announced her new love. Porsha's engagement to her co-star's ex-husband Simon seems to be pretty controversial to fans, but it seems that she's in love. Porsha's net worth has fluctuated significantly since joining the cast of Real Housewives. When we were first introduced to her and she was married to her NFL star ex, her net worth was at an impressive $16 million. But once they divorced, there was a prenup and Cordell stated he didn't have to pay Porsha any spousal support due to the short time they were together, and she walked away with no money. Real Housewives star's net worth is now somewhere around $500K to $1 million, but she's slowly rebuilding her wealth, considering post-divorce it was only $200K. With her hard work and new ventures, Porsha was able to invest in her current mansion in 2016 for $1.15 million, and the place is beautiful. Hey guys, it's Carrie the Vampire Slayer, and I'm bringing you another house tour here on Famous Entertainment. I noticed a bunch of you guys watching our videos aren't subscribed, so be sure to hit that subscribe button and ring that bell and help us get to 1 million subs. We post a new video daily. Today we're gonna take a look at Real Housewives of Atlanta star Porsha Williams and where she calls home, like her one-time abode with her ex-husband, and more importantly, her current Duluth mansion she lives at. This is the same home she often features on her Instagram, and the place is gorgeous. If you like this video, check out our recent one on Nene Leaks, which we'll link to at the end, and keep your eye out for some more Real Housewives house tours. As always, don't forget to follow me on Instagram to chat, and now, let's get into this video. Of course, before Porsha's messy divorce from Cordell, the couple lived in an Atlanta mansion when they were first featured on the show. This was their marital home that her ex-husband had kept post-divorce, and while we don't know all of the details, we can remember how the place looked. Not to mention, the home spanned a massive 12,500 square feet of space. Walking in the mega mansion, there's a large double-height foyer with a staircase to add some glamour, and back in the ex-couple's happier days, they had their marriage certificate and a photo out in the front hall. Actually, their portraits were everywhere. Arched doorways led into a formal living room with fireplace and cream and mocha colored furniture, as well as French doors to outside. Nearby, there was a formal dining room with luxury chandelier, and then the massive kitchen had a workspace, rich wooden cabinets, and bar seating for six. The kitchen opened up into the family room, which was my favorite space, where there were soaring wood-beamed ceilings, a large stone fireplace, and plenty of earth tones. While this mansion was beautiful, Porsha moved into a luxury rental after the couple was divorced. However, she ran into some drama there as the landlord said she was behind on her rent. Like I said, the reality TV queen worked hard to rebuild her wealth, and after landing a job as a host on Dish Nation, she was soon able to get her money up again. Porsha scored herself a gorgeous home in Duluth all by herself in 2016, which we're gonna check out next. In 2016, Porsha treated herself to her current home located in Duluth, Georgia, where her former Real Housewives cast member Nene Leakes lives a few minutes away from her. We can see it's the same home Porsha still still lives in, considering she shows it off all the time, especially that lavish foyer. The home cost her $1.15 million, and it was the first big investment she had made since her divorce from Stuart. Situated on a lot that spans 3/4 of an acre of land, this home is located just off of Sugarloaf Parkway in Duluth, about 30 minutes from the heart of Atlanta, Georgia, and located within a golf course community. As you might have guessed, Porsha's mansion is nothing short of luxurious, boasting a columned entryway and impressive details before you even step foot inside. Walking in, there's that impressive entryway with marble flooring, which Porsha often features in her selfies, as well as a dramatic winding staircase leading upstairs and double height ceilings. This estate spans 5,290 square feet with 5 beds, 7 baths, and 5 fireplaces throughout as well. Porsha's mansion has gorgeous millwork and details, as well as an amazing chef's kitchen with top-of-the-line appliances and large island that opens to a hearth-side breakfast room and what listing materials call a keeping room. This looks to me like a cozy den surrounded by French doors. Here, there's a stone fireplace and a flat-screen TV. This level also boasts a classic wood-paneled officer library, as well as the impressive great room. The great room has double-height ceilings, a white fireplace, and full wall of windows for natural light. Porsha's master suite could double as an apartment looking at the size of the space. On one end, there's a sitting area nestled into a wall of windows and features like another fireplace and vaulted ceilings. As you might expect, there's an equally luxurious attached bath decked out in marble finishes, and even the bathtub is flanked in columns. There's also a separate vanity here, separate shower, and a flat screen TV. The listing described Porsha's master closet as well appointed, but we can see that it's more like a large bedroom. Honestly, the size of this closet is my dream. The guest rooms also offer ensuite so family can sleep comfortably, and some were finished as children's rooms at the time of the sale. Elsewhere, there's a sprawling balcony and a covered terrace on the ground level, not to mention a large unfinished basement, which had potential to turn into another great entertainment space. Porsha was really proud of her milestone buying a home and told her followers at the time, "I closed on my first home today after my divorce, and I have to say I thank God and love where I'm at in my life. No regrets, lessons learned. Hashtag best revenge is your paper. Won't he do it? God bless the child that got his own." With touches like arches over the fireplace, all the columns, and more, Porsha's home is a little over the top, but it's still classy with wood paneling and a red brick exterior. Not to mention, her daughter has a luxury lounge space of her own. Her unique bedroom was full of oversized stuffed animals, a black accent wall, a milk bar, and at the time, the baby's crib, which was flanked by metallic angel wings. Porsha even decks her mansion out for the holidays just like she did this past Christmas. She did a traditional yet still fancy Christmas tree with a lot of burgundy and gold, and got help from a designer to make her home look perfect. Porsha said since 2020 was a tough year, she wanted to bring in the festive vibes. She told People, "Whenever someone comes over to my house, now that it's completely transformed into Christmas land, it just sets the tone. Their energy is lifted, they feel fun, joyful. All of that is part of the holiday. It might be basically summertime right now, but that just made me miss Christmas." Now that we've taken a look at the homes of Real Housewives of Atlanta star Porsha Williams, I think I'll wrap up this house tour. After checking out her current mansion, what did you guys think? Do you like it better than the one she shared a long time ago with her ex-husband? Cause I do. Porsha decorated her current estate super beautifully, and the home is luxurious to say the least. Definitely fit for a queen. My favorite rooms have gotta be the great room, Porsha's master suite, and that room-sized walk-in closet. Be sure to tell me yours down in the comments. I've also been reading all your comments on our house tours lately, and I'm gonna be shouting you guys out again. I love sharing and seeing what you guys have to say about these gorgeous celebrity homes. These are from our recent Nene Leakes house tour. Alice Walker said, "Nene has some beautiful homes, but this one right here is awesome. It's so well decorated to her liking for herself and family. I'm so glad that she left the Real Housewives of Atlanta. She has gotten more mature and a smart businesswoman. The Duluth, Georgia home is awesome. I love her current home too. It's the best to settle down in by far. She has style." And Rebecca L. wrote, "Thank you for doing this video. I love Nene Leakes. Could you do videos on the other housewives like Kyle Richards or Candy Burris?" Thanks, Rebecca. I'm actually working on more of the Real Housewives videos as we speak, so keep your eye out. If you want me to shout out your comment next, be sure to drop one below and tell me what you thought about the homes Porsha Williams lives at. If you haven't, go subscribe to my personal channel because I would love to get to know all of you better. We'll link you my latest video. On August 20th, 1989, Jose and Kitty Menendez were found dead in the den of their own home. There's a group of TikTokers who
who are trying to raise awareness to release these brothers from jail who killed their parents, named the Menendez brothers.
Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to follow me over on Instagram, and I will see you guys all in the next video. Bye.